I'm at the designated spot.
You got what we talked about?
All his bank transfers, all his overseas transactions.
We're 20 minutes away.
Wait. I just heard something. Stevens. No. Wait.
Can you get a picture? So what's his name again, this guy you work for?
Frank Chase. Import-export. He's got his own air freight business, too.
So you're a night watchman now, or what?
You know any night watchmen make a grand a week?
Hey, you need anybody else?
You never know. Why, you're not happy working with your dad?
I put Pop in a huge hole financially. I gotta find a way to make it right.
Let me see what I can do.
Hangar 12 coming off Elgin. I'll be waiting for you.
All right. On my way.
Took you so long.
What are you talking about?
I called you 11 minutes ago.
How many planes does this guy have?
Not that many. What he does is he imports and exports luxury items for rich people. So it's a smaller quantity, but a bigger bottom line than you might think.
So when did you start sounding like a suit?
Got my eyes on something bigger than security detail, man. You know what I'm saying? This right here, Mitch, this is my future. Now those guys over there, they're unloading wine. It's like $8,000 a bottle.
Yeah, great. I'll flip it in a 9 grand worth of beer and we can have a party.
Have it off already. Gooch, who's your friend?
Mr. Chase, this is Mitch Campanella.
Mitch, it's a pleasure.
Likewise. Sounds like your timing's a little off.
Is that what it is?
Yeah. Want me to take a look?
Be my guest.
You want to fire it up for me?
Yes, sir.
Oh, oh. Just a little. Go ahead, turn the engine over. Let me hear it.
That is terrific.
So you got somebody looking after this thing for you?
I do. I have a mechanic up at the house. I'll be quite honest with you, Mitch. He has never had this engine running quite this smoothly. I'm very impressed.
Tell you what, I could stop by and talk to your guy. Set him straight on a couple things about the car. If, you know, you're up for it.
What's this? It might be. Here we go again.
Oh.
Mr. Chase, I have a warrant to search that cargo over there.
Just try not to break anything, all right?
I'll do my best.
No drugs? No weapons?
Not this time.
See that, Mitch? Get to the top, everybody tries to bring you down. Pooch, why don't you take your friend to the house and show him the rest of the cars?
Yes, sir.
See if you can give Agent Matthews and her monkeys something else to focus on for a little while.
I think I come up with something.
Good.
All these years, you still drive like an old lady.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh.
No.
No, no, no. That is Jesse, Chase's daughter. So I can't look?
What'd I say?
All right.
Haven't filled the usual paperwork. When he's done, take him out of the garage and have him meet Eddie.
You just got hired.
Vlasic.
Yeah.
Mitch is gonna give you a hand with the cars.
Well, I don't need a hand.
Mr. Chase thinks you do.
He didn't say anything to me.
Do you hear what I'm telling you?
It's all right, Gooch.
Why don't you let me do my job? He's working here now. End of story.
Sorry about that.
You like him?
Mr. Chase, I can't thank you enough for this. I mean, next to driving, this is a dream come true.
Yeah, Gooch told me you used to race.
Yeah, I did.
Well, this isn't quite as exciting, but it pays well. All I ask is one thing, that you have my cars ready for me when I need them, okay?
I will, sir, and I won't forget this.
All right, good. Vlasic over here. He'll show you where everything is, won't you, Vlasic?
Absolutely.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you, sir.
Vlasic, I'll need the Mercedes.
You got it, Mr. Chase.
Where the hell have you been?
You're not gonna believe it.
You don't show up at work, you don't call in sick, you don't tell anybody nothing about where you are.
I got another job.
Another job?
That's what I'm saying. I'll be drawing $1,200 a week.
Come on, stop farting around. Now call Riley, tell him you had an accident or something like that. He'll dock you one day's pay and that's it.
Pop, you're not listening. I'm working somewhere else.
Doing what?
I'm a mechanic.
$1,200 a week, you're what, working on cars?
His garage you would kill for.
How'd you get this job?
Gooch put me onto it. Gooch.
Pop! What's important is I'll finally be able to pay you back for the money you sunk into the car.
Let me ask you, this guy, You have health insurance? You offer you a pension plan?
I don't know. Maybe that comes later. But what I do know is I am finally making some real money.
I don't like it.
I'm not asking you to like it. Hey, did you have dinner?
No, I was waiting for you.
Order a pizza?
Pepperoni. None of that veggie crap, all right?
You might want to reattach those clamps better. First time this baby idle's rough, they're gonna come apart.
I need your advice, I'll ask for it.
Sorry.
Morning, Eddie.
Miss Chase.
And, who are you?
Mitch.
Mitch. I didn't know we had a Mitch working for us.
You know now.
I'm gonna need a car in half an hour. Pull it out front for me.
Which one?
You decide.
Well, what's the occasion?
I'm meeting a few friends that I went to school with. Sort of a reunion.
Take the Cobra. Make them eat their hearts out.
Perfect. Thanks.
Matthews. Yeah, they confirmed someone bought the Red Mercury from the Russians.
Yeah, I read the report.
It was Chase. I know it was.
They finished the first leg. In Germany on its way to France.
I don't like putting it on one of your planes.
I'm not. You take care of that little item I mentioned?
Yeah, I'll be on the news tonight. Nobody got hurt, but they'll keep them busy trying to figure out who, what, and why.
Can't wait to see it. What happened?
I don't think your new mechanic is working out.
Fix it.
I'll take care of it, Mr. Chase.
Yo.
That hose is just, it's disconnected. The clamp didn't hold. Who worked on this?
The kid, he checked it out for your daughter.
Mitch.
People try to run a game on me. Bad things happen.
I tighten those clamps.
I believe you. I need people around me that I can trust, Mitch. Play along with me.
Don't you ever let this happen again, you understand me? You screw up one more time like this, and you're through here.
Many of you know that an attempt was made on my life. So I'm taking this one personally. From now on, we put everything we've got into Frank Chase.
And we've been working on this guy for how long?
Obviously not long enough. Because we're gonna keep working on him until we bring him down. I want Chase in solitary and you're gonna put him there. I don't care how many birthdays you miss or who gets divorced. Let's get to work.
What are you eating? Doesn't matter. Change. I'm taking you to lunch.
Pick up your bag.
The first few years were rough. But, Mitch, people learn that they can depend on you provide is promised, that's when the business just starts coming your way.
Sounds like I could learn a lot from you, Mr. Chase.
Ever been married?
No, sir.
Very smart. My wife left me and Jesse. Classic story. I paid far too much attention to my work and not my personal life, and she took a walk. Please pull up a chair and join us.
Has he given you that old song and a dance yet about his troubled life? Standard bullshit for new recruits. People have a tendency to disappear around this man. His wife, for instance.
You're out of line.
You're lucky no one got hurt today. May I? Enjoy your lunch, gentlemen.
Here you go, Mr. Chase.
This car hasn't driven this well since I took it off the showroom floor. You can do this to all my cars, right, Mitch?
I'm gonna try.
Buckle up, son. Start your engines.
Car back there.
I think you're right. Looks like he's chasing someone. I better get out of the way.
May or may not have left you a present in the passenger seat.
You're all right. Here you go, my friend. Officer, you found my car.
Mr. Chase.
What took you so long?
Well?
I'm kidding.
We found it in a parking area. Some kids probably took it for a joyride.
Boys will be boys.
Well, they were gonna take it to impound, but told them I'd take care of it.
Who drove it over here?
Me. Couldn't resist.
Good. Next time you get the urge, you drop by. We'll take it out, okay?
I'll do that, Mr. Chase. Thank you.
You take care, Tommy.
You reported it stolen.
Boys will be boys.
This is nuts.
Life is short, my son.
Almost was.
Relax, Mitch. You'll live longer. Get that car in the back.
Yes, Mr. Chase. Let's get a drink after work.
Hey,
hell'd you bring me out here for, Gooch? I thought we were going somewhere for a drink.
Aw, oh, man, it's like old times. Remember?
Who's your girlfriend?
You better show some respect, man.
No, man, I'm just playing with you. Mitch Campanella. I heard you blew your big shot. Now you're coming back here to be the man? Don't work that way, bro.
Let's go. All right.
I take you on right now. Seriously, I ain't afraid of you. Tell him who I am, Gooch.
Nobody.
Some other time, kid.
You afraid of me?
He doesn't have his ride.
Lend him yours, dude.
All right, you want to kick his ass?
Nah, it's too easy.
Come on, man. Want to go up against a legend?
He said no.
Yeah? Well, I knew you lost your car. Didn't know you lost your guts.
He said no. Go.
Forget about that guy, man. He's a punk. Let's get out of here.
Let's go get those drinks. Come on.
I need something on this guy.
Look, I just can't keep walking around this place looking for something.
I understand that, but we need to stick our necks out here.
All right, I'll do what I can. Look, Chase hired this kid. Male, Caucasian, 20-something, Campanella Mitch. He's only been there a couple of days, but already they're pretty tight.
Yeah, I met him. You remember how to use these, right?
How many times do you want me to copy this guy's hard drive?
Until we find something we can use.
I think he suspects me. There's nothing I can put my finger on, it's just...
You need help, call us. We'll be right there.
Yeah.
It's me. See what you can dig up on a white male mid-20s named Campanella? Mitch Mitchell, yeah, the one from the airport. Let me know. Always this foggy out.
I wouldn't know. I live in the valley. It's always sunny there. Still spectacular, though.
So I hear you went for a ride with my dad.
We took a spin, yeah?
One of these days he'll get caught.
You know about this?
Oh, yeah. I've been on a couple of his rides. You know, I need someone to drive me to Beverly Hills later.
I'd love to help you out, but I get off at 6.
Well, you would be paid, of course.
Jesse, your father's looking for you.
In a minute.
He wants you now.
And I said, in a minute.
I'm just a messenger.
What car do you want?
The Cobra. 6:30, sharp.
Maybe I didn't make myself clear.
About what?
You were hired to work on the cars, not Jesse. Just get back to work.
Hey, you're home.
Yeah. And I gotta go out again.
Hey, wait a minute. Have a beer. Thought maybe we go out and get something to eat.
Can't pop. Driving the boss's daughter.
Rule number one, you stay away from the boss's daughter. Rule number two, stay away from the boss's daughter.
Yeah, yeah, I've been hearing that all day.
Yeah? Then maybe you better listen. Stupid bastard.
Yourself. I'll be out here when you're done.
No, you'll be joining me.
No. I get paid to drive.
No, you get paid to do whatever I tell you to do.
Whatever you say, boss.
some Cosmos.
Yes.
He's got it.
Thank you. I called ahead and ordered a bottle of champagne. I hope that's okay.
I'm more of a beer man myself. So, do you always go to drinks with your driver?
Usually, no.
Usually, I don't go places with girls where the food isn't served in buns. Don't you ever just talk to someone?
What do you mean?
Tell me something important about yourself.
I don't have any friends.
None?
Not one. And I swear to God, if you say, oh, I'll be your friend, I will stick a fork in your head.
Right now, more than any other time, I find you irresistible.
You're so weird. Okay, now you tell me something important about yourself.
I'm still a virgin.
You! Ah! I knew I shouldn't have trusted you.
The package. It leaves the country tonight. Is that satisfactory?
Fine. Let me know when it arrives.
A man with the package?
We are close, Carl. Just tell our people to keep a low profile. The FBI is just waiting for us to screw up.
Anything else?
Why don't you go to the house and I'll meet you there in an hour.
There's something about being left behind. My mother left us a long time ago, and I always blame myself.
I can relate.
What about your dad? What does he do?
He works in a warehouse. And I owe him a lot.
Yeah. Same with my dad.
So what do you do for him? I mean, you work for him, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I deal with most of his overseas contacts. I'm currently in the process of bringing his operation to the 21st century with computers. He's kind of a technophobe. Likes to keep everything in his head.
Checking your email.
Very good. No, I'll make the arrangements. Okay, I will see you then. This is Chase.
We got
got a situation. I need you back at the house.
I'm leaving now.
Anything from your guy?
He called earlier. Said he was going in.
How long ago was that?
Yeah. No, not yet. I'll let you know. This is the part I hate.
Get used to it.
Your old man would think it's so cool.
Well, you can walk me to my door, can't you?
Getting so you can't trust anyone. Did he tell you anything?
No. Nope. Go to work. Did he wouldn't have been in your office.
Two more days and we're home free.
What do you want me to do with him?
Put him where they'll find him.
been quite a while.
Yeah.
You want to go get him?
Yeah, let's pull him out. Matthews. Where is he? Right. He's dead.
What the hell are you, Ben?
Pop.
You know I made dinner for us?
Pop. Listen. I'm in trouble.
All right.
So you ever gonna say it?
Say what?
I told you so.
If you wouldn't mind, Detective. I'm Special Agent Matthews. This is my boss, Agent Collin. The man you saw killed last night, he was one of our agents.
Vlasic?
That's right. He was assigned to infiltrate Frank Chase's organization.
What's going on here?
We believe that Frank Chase may be involved in the importation of red mercury.
Which is what?
A substance used to detonate a fusion bomb.
Frank Chase is a terrorist?
Worse. He's a profiteer that'll do anything to make money.
Let's just say he aids and abets terrorism.
You work for him.
I'm not going back.
Actually, we'd like you to reconsider that.
Now, wait a minute.
Mr. Campanella, your son is the only direct link to Chase that we have, and we need somebody on the inside to let us know when the red mercury is going to be delivered.
No, no, forget it. He's not trained for this. I mean, you just lost one of your people. Now you want him to go in and take his place? No. No, look, why can't you just arrest Chase for murder? I mean, you got a witness sitting right here.
Yeah, and tomorrow there'll be 10 people swearing he was in Beverly Hills when it happened. It won't work.
I still say forget it. I don't want my son going anywhere near that place.
Well, consider this, Mr. Campanella. If he doesn't show up for work tomorrow, then they'll know he saw something.
What do you mean?
They'll kill him.
All right. But if I'm going to risk my life, I want a couple things in return.
Name it.
I want Gooch out of there. Take him somewhere where he can't be hurt.
And?
Money. For my dad. Mitch.
How much?
$60,000.
Depending on what you bring us, we can probably handle that. In return, I'm gonna need you to plant this in Chase's office.
What is this, a bug?
Just place it somewhere inconspicuous.
Vlasic put one in his office, but they found it.
Mr. Mustafa, just calling to make sure that everything is okay on your end. And the cash? Good. Nope, no problems here. I look forward to seeing you. Mustafa's still in. He and his people will be here Thursday to hammer out the final details. Make sure that Jesse's here for the meet, will you?
She'll be here. Anything else?
Yeah. We can't have any more lapses in judgment. We can't afford another Vlasic.
I'm on it.
Day. Ah, oh, you're
Morning, sweetheart. What time did you get in last night?
I got in early.
What time?
About midnight.
Were you alone?
Mitch drove me.
You invite him in?
Of course not. I know the rules, Daddy.
Go right to bed?
Okay, what's with the third degree? What's going on?
I thought I saw someone walking around last night.
Oh, it's probably Gooch. He never goes home.
Probably.
Mitch.
Whoa.
You see Mr. Chase today?
No. Why?
I stopped for coffee, right?
Yeah?
Feds tried to pick me up.
What?
FBI.
No way. What for?
Come on. Something bad happened last night, and they're trying to put it all on me.
What are you talking about?
I'm going to see Mr. Chase.
Gooch, wait a second. You said it's the FBI, right?
Yeah.
Now, maybe you shouldn't talk to Mr. Chase.
No, he can help me.
Look,
if they were after you, he's going to think maybe you're going to give him up.
He's not going to be able to trust you anymore.
What are you talking about?
He's got to figure sooner or later they're going to catch up to you. Maybe you make a deal, roll over on him.
What are you talking about? What do you know about Mr. Chase?
Come on, Gooch. A guy with this kind of money, you know he's into something bad.
You better watch what you say.
Sure. I'm just saying, look out for number one, you know?
Yeah, maybe you're right. All right, just forget we even said anything about this, okay?
Sure.
And I we're still friends. I mean, right? I know I've been
don't
riding your heart.
Don't worry about it.
Thanks.
All right, be cool.
Yeah.
Matthews.
Gooch was just here. What happened to our deal?
We tried to get him, Mitch. He got away.
I want him out of here. I want him protected.
In the meantime, do you have that little item that we discussed?
Yeah.
Chase's office, all right?
Yeah, I'll try.
Who are you talking to?
My dad. What's up?
Did Eddie come in yet?
No, he's running a little late.
Oh.
Is your dad around?
Yeah, he's around the corner with Stevens.
Oh, hey, what are you doing?
Oh, coward. Look, I am going to come back later and make your day special.
It's probably not a good idea.
But that's what I want. And I always get what I want.
Where's Eddie?
Eddie?
Eddie Vlasic, the guy you work with.
I don't know.
Did you talk to him yesterday?
Hello? Goodbye? You know?
Must have quit. It happens. People just stop coming in.
Yeah?
If you got a problem, you come to me.
Thanks.
Oh, if Eddie comes in, you let me know.
Sure.
I'm just glad we were able to come to equitable terms.
As long as you deliver the red mercury, the money will be there.
Guaranteed. Please allow me to introduce you to my daughter, Jessie.
May I compliment you on your beauty?
Thank you.
Until we meet again.
Thank you. My daughter will walk you out.
I hope your hotel is satisfactory.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
And feel free to ask for anything you need.
Get changed. Going to the airport.
Sure.
Pull over.
Now?
Yeah, now. Walk with me.
have to pee. Thing is, I don't think Eddie's coming back.
No?
No. He say anything to you?
Like what?
I don't know. Unhappy with his job. There's something else going on.
We never talked that much.
He never said anything?
Well, he'd say something. I don't want to mention it to you.
What'd he say, Mitch?
He said you're an asshole.
He said that?
And a little more, but you get the picture.
Huh. You know what? I changed my mind. Let's go back to the house.
Hey, quitting time.
Yeah, already?
Take me out.
Where do you want to go?
I was talking to Gooch, and he said that there was some place you guys used to go to race.
Nah, that's no good.
But I want to see you drive.
You want to see me?
Where is Gooch? I haven't seen him all day.
Yeah, nobody's seen him.
Find him. Bring him here.
So, this is where you started?
Yeah. It's not much, is it? So, you want to see me race?
So much out there, I never felt anything like it.
You didn't show up for work. Carl tells me he finds you packing a bag. I have to tell you, Gooch, my feelings were hurt.
Mr. Chase, I didn't mean nothing.
You're trying to run like a thief in the night.
I just got scared is all.
Scared? Of what, me?
No,
come on, have a drink. I'm not going to ruin a good scotch, Gooch. What were you doing?
Well, the feds were all over me. They chased me, and I lost them. I don't know, I didn't want to lead them back to you.
Gooch, I like you, but I need to know that I can trust you.
Mr. Chase, what do I have to do?
I don't know, Carl, what does he have to do?
Do what you're told.
Finish your drink.
Downstairs, I thought I heard somebody in here. What?
Daddy doesn't want anybody in here. Not even me.
I know. I thought somebody was breaking in.
Well, just don't let it happen again. Ooh, somebody ready for round four?
Yeah, I need something to go with the drink first.
Me.
I better get going.
But you don't want to stay and play?
It's late. I gotta go.
You don't leave unless I say you leave. No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean that.
Right. I'll see you later, okay?
No, wait, please. Please don't go. I just don't like to be alone. We could have so much fun together.
Pop, I can't do this to Jesse. If her father goes to jail, he's going to take her right along with him.
Well, if she's not involved...
She's part of the business. She's right in the middle of it. He goes down, she goes down.
Well, that's not your concern.
Well, it isn't. Jesse's not like her dad.
Look, son, I know how you feel, but... sometimes innocent people get hurt and there's nothing you can do about it.
Are you sure?
Yes. I caught him in your office. He said someone was trying to break in.
And you think the real reason is what?
He's a Fed. Either that or he's working for the Feds.
Oh, come on. He's not a Fed.
Found this bug in your office under the desk. It wasn't there this morning when I swept.
Son of a bitch. I told you to keep an eye on him.
I did.
No, you did not. You were not supposed to sleep with him or let him ever run into this house. Now I'm getting fed up with your attitude.
First of all, I didn't sleep with him. And second, it's none of your business.
It's none of my business? You are jeopardizing my business. This deal is too big, and we are too close for you to screw it up by playing around with the help. Do you understand me? Yes? Good girl.
What do you want to do with the bug?
Let's use it to our advantage.
Call just came in. Give me some good news. The package is in country. Any problems?
No. They're just waiting for us to let them know the rendezvous point.
5 p.m., the rail yard in San Dimas.
San Dimas? I'll make the call.
Got a minute?
Yeah, have a seat.
Internet traffic's off the charts. Whatever it is, it's big, and it's gonna be Monday night.
You sure?
The bug Mitch planted confirms a meeting Monday. Tap reveals they're meeting in the rail yard in San Dimas.
No. Chase's air freight.
No. They know we're watching his planes, right? So they bring it in by boat or a commercial airline thousands of miles from here. Then they put it on a train for final delivery.
So what we're talking about here is a buy, not an actual terrorist attack.
The important thing is, whatever they're doing, we'll be there to stop them.
Yeah. Get on it.
Sorry, I didn't mean to scare
you. What are you doing here?
I want to,
You can't just walk in here like that.
I have to talk to you.
Look, I can't right now.
Well, Jesse, listen.
I gotta go meet my dad.
Wait, it's important.
Whoa, what?
Hey, I'm sorry. Couldn't let them drag you down along with your father.
And you expect me to believe all this?
I told you so you could step away from this before it's too late. Jess! Jesse. Hey, listen to me.
Tell me something interesting about yourself, Mitch. Something personal.
Jesse.
Don't go. I don't want you to leave me. Please stay. You're a good lay, but my God, you are so naive. Like I could ever really fall for someone like you.
Yeah.
Yeah, come up to the house.
Now. You know, the biggest problem I was having was how to get rid of this greasy little nobody when I was done with him. Oh, problem solved.
What's wrong?
Him. Look, get rid of him. I don't care how, just get rid of him. And when you're done, meet me at the airport.
The airport? No, 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 your dad went to San Dimas.
No, he didn't.
Come on.
You stupid bastard, what were you thinking?
Coach, you don't get it. A lot of people are gonna get... Going down today at the airport.
San Dimas at the rail yard.
No, listen to me. I heard Jesse say she was going to meet her dad. She told Gooch to meet them at the airport.
Are you certain?
Yes.
Damn it.
Come on, move it. Get all those on the truck.
Yeah.
Mr. Chase.
You're right about Mitch. He's working for the FBI. He broke my leg.
What?
Mitch works for the FBI. Is he a family?
He lives with his father. Want me to pick him up?
Yeah, I want you to pick him up. I need insurance. God.
Pop, you here? Pop! Pop, you here?
Yeah?
We have your father.
Chase?
Mitch! Don't listen to him, Mitch!
We're at the airport.
Chase, it's me!
Good to see you, Mitch.
For God's sakes, will somebody kill him already?
Pop, you all right?
I'm all right. You shouldn't have come here.
I trust that you kept this all to yourself.
I didn't tell anybody. You let my dad go, and I'll do whatever you want.
Hell with that.
Pop!
I'll take care of it, all right?
You and your pop are gonna take a plane ride. Try a little skydiving over the ocean.
Excuse me.
Yeah. Okay. Carl, it's on the ground. Start refueling the plane and unloading the cargo. Honey, do me a favor, keep our friends company.
Again.
It's a pleasure. I hope everything is to your satisfaction.
No doubt it will.
It is a pleasure to do business with someone so completely trustworthy.
You honor us. So, do you have the money? Green, my favorite color.
Well said. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Yeah.
Left with him. And don't bother lying to me.
You okay, Pop?
Why, don't I look okay?
Just drive, huh? Yeah, you're okay.
How much did you tell him?
I didn't tell him anything. You're the one who told him.
Yeah. I told him you're a psychotic little bitch that I could never trust.
You drove my mother away.
Because she was insane. She was ruining everything. Don't look at me like that. You never cared for her, or anybody else for that matter. You used her like you used me all these years. Who do you think pays for all your shit? Your cars and your toys and your hair appointments? Me and my money. And without my money, you'd be in a nut house.
Really?
Really. Are they shooting at us?
Take a wild guess, but I'd say yeah.
Are they blind? That's your own truck! God's sakes. Don't be stupid. I'm your father. I'm all you've got. Put that down.
I'm not going down for you.
Do as I say, Jesse.
I have my whole life ahead of me.
Yeah, a life that I gave you.
You messed up everything. You got lazy, and you got sloppy. You're going down, and I am not going down with you.
You think the feds are gonna believe you're not involved? You are in up to your spoiled little head.
Shut up.
You might as well shoot me, honey. Because I will kill you. I am not letting you walk away scot-free.
I said it. Shut up!
Put it down.
This one's dead. Someone get her patched up before she bleeds to death. Start searching the plane.
Let's get it packaged into the morgue.
How many more to go?
As soon as she's able to travel, I want to transport her to the hospital and get that body inside. Agent, do not let her out of your sight.
Matthews, what do we got?
Not a damn thing.
Hey, you all right?
Yeah. Listen, what you did took guts, and I appreciate it.
I'm just sorry the way it turned out.
Well, we didn't get what we came for, but it's not a total loss. This is Premier Grand Cru, and this blue-collar nobody's gonna have a taste. Care to join me? Hold on to that. Don't drop it. There we go. Gently.
I'll be damned.
$10,000 bottle of wine and the cork's petrified.
Here, let an Italian show you how to do that.
Here, give me that. Let me see your gun. Thank you.
Nice work, son, but we were after the wine. Your whatchamacallit?
This is the Red Mercury, Pop.
Hey, done good.
Gentlemen, every single case of wine in that plane needs to be completely isolated.
It's too bad.
What's that?
She's awful pretty.
Yeah, but she's certifiable.
Nobody's perfect.
Boy, you got that right.
Better.
Well, don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.